In this video, we will set up a continuous integration and a continuous deployment pipeline using GitHub Actions. The first thing we need to check is the structure of the app is correct. In my app, I've got the main app has a config and an init file, and also roots. Then I have the run file, which runs the whole application. There is also a tests folder, a static folder, and a templates folder. I'm using unit testing and I only have a very basic test called base.py, but you will notice that later in the video I changed the name of base.py as I realized this was not correct for continuous integration. Another important thing to do is create a requirements.txt file. I already have one, and you can see that if I write pip freeze requirements.txt, it gives me all the different requirements that I have. But if you want to create the file, you can do pip freeze -r requirements.txt. And this will automatically create your requirements.txt file like I have here. Something else you need to make sure you have is a GitHub repository for your application. Once you have all of these requirements, we can start adding our continuous integration. For this, we will use GitHub Actions, as I said, and you can just create a new workflow. And if you scroll down, you can look for Python application. In the Python application, if you click on set up this workflow, it will automatically set up a basic workflow for you and you can just edit this. You can specify when you want this workflow to happen and you can specify what this workflow will do. So let's commit this file. And by committing it, it will automatically create a GitHub workflow folder in which you will have the workflow in it. So if we pull in our PyCharm, you can see that you have the workflow now created inside a GitHub workflows folder. Right now we have this set up so that continuous integration happens every time we push to the master branch or we pull from the master branch. I only actually want the workflow to run if there is a push, not a pull. So I'm going to delete the pull one. Another thing I want to change is I'm running on a macOS and not on a Ubuntu machine, so I'm going to change that. And the rest I'm going to leave it as it is. So there are certain jobs we define. For example, installing dependencies here is where you install the requirements.txt from the requirements.txt file, which is why it's important you have that file. We then have the lint with flake8, which just checks syntax errors. And then we have test with pytest, which actually runs our test from our test folder. So if we commit this, every time we push, remember, this is gonna run the workflow. And in our workflow, the last test is we run pytest. So it should run our tests. And you can see the workflow as it runs. My workflow actually failed the first time. And the reason it failed is because it couldn't find where the app is. So we can define this using the command export Python path equals app and make sure there's no spaces. Once we push this again, the test should run once again in the GitHub. My test failed, and actually it failed many more times, about 11 times. And I realized that the reason it failed was because I got the naming conventions wrong. So it's actually supposed to be named test underscore and whatever you're testing. I did mention this at the beginning, but this is why everything went wrong. So we can commit this again. Push it. And once it's pushed, we can check how it's doing in GitHub. So it runs through every part of the workflow. And you can see that everything is successful. So now that we set up continuous integration, we're onto the final part, which is implementing continuous deployment. I will be using Heroku because it's free and it's very simple to implement. The first thing we need to do is install the Heroku CLI, and this can be done on their website. The only problem is that it has a brew command, and for Mac people this is not very good news, so you will need to install homebrew so that it can actually run this command. Once you run first the homebrew and then this command on the terminal, you can check if you have Heroku successfully installed by just writing Heroku on the terminal. And then once you have that, you can sign up to Heroku. And then you can log in through the terminal by doing Heroku login. And now we can create our app. We can either do this in the Heroku dashboard, or we can actually do it from the terminal by doing Heroku space create, but I'm actually going to do it from the dashboard because that's easier. So you just fill in all the details, create the app, and this creates a new app where you can connect your GitHub repository. So if you click on that and connect it to GitHub, it will log you into your GitHub account. You can authorize Heroku. And once it's authorized, you can select what your project name is, and this is just the repository name. It will find it, you can connect it, and then there's a few options for deployment. There's the automatic deployment, but then there's also the manual deployment, which you can actually do on the terminal as well by doing git push Heroku master. Or you can just do it manually from their dashboard. But we're going to do the automatic deployment as we're doing continuous integration and continuous deployment. In order to deploy onto Heroku, we do need to put in our credentials for the Heroku, but we don't actually want this to be public for everyone. So what we can do is we can create a token that will be used for authentication instead of putting our username and password. To create a token, you simply go to the Heroku website for the API, creating an API, and you can copy the command of Heroku authorizations create. And this will actually create a lifetime user authentication, which you can access via this token. The way we put this token in GitHub is through secrets so that nobody can see it. And if you create the new secret, you can give it a variable name by which you will refer to it in our workflow. You paste the token in there. And then the other thing I also created was the app name. This is not actually necessary, but I just put it in there. And put the app name as the value. Now we can use these in our workflow. To write the job of the run, for deploying, I've actually split it into two sections. The first section is adding the remote to the origin, and it only runs if the tests were successful. Then the second part of the run is deploying to Heroku. It's kind of like what we do with GitHub, that we first commit and then we push our changes. If we now try and push this into GitHub and run the workflow, it's not actually going to work because we need some other files to be adding onto our application. So even though everything does run successfully, if we try and access our web application, it does give us an error, application error. First thing we need to do is add a proc file, and in the proc file there will be a very simple line of code which says web JUnicorn. And then the run is where you run the application, and the app is where your application is contained. Another file we need to add is the runtime.txt. And in here we specify the version of Python for Heroku. And the last thing we need to do is in our requirements.txt we add JUnicorn. We also need to install it. I use the shortcut Option Shift Enter. But you can also add it manually if you need to. So now if we commit everything onto GitHub and we push, the workflow should run once again. We can check on GitHub. And for me, everything was successful, but I actually got an application error once again. And the only reason I got an application error was because I misspelled proc file, as I mentioned earlier. So make sure it's not proc'd file, it's proc file. So once I renamed that, I also added an unshallow command. And when I committed it, it worked successfully. So hopefully you can implement continuous integration and continuous deployment in your own application, and I hope this video helped. Note that most of this video I've based on another video that I've watched on YouTube that I will put in the description. And that one actually explains everything in much more detail, but for some people that might be too much detail. So this is kind of the surface to continuous integration and continuous deployment. If you want to understand every part of it, you can watch the other video that I will link in the description.